In the previous chapters, we discussed things like basic console operation and basic network configuration. Now we're going to take a look at some more advanced topics. These are things like multiple console setups, adding additional I/O devices, gain compensation, and a host of other topics. First, let's think about that R-series device and the unit ID. As we discussed earlier, setting the unit ID determines how your channels are going to land on your console. Unit ID number 1 usually lands at the top, while unit ID number 2 usually lands on the second layer. If we wish to add additional R-series devices to our console, we have to make sure that we set the unit ID properly and mount them to the desk so that we can receive that audio. Let's take a look at the Dante setup page and see how we can mount those devices, as well as change things like our unit ID and our latency settings. Let's go over the Dante setup parameters in more detail. The first thing I'll do is touch on I/O device and then touch Dante setup. Here, we're looking at the setup tab where we can configure the settings for our console. If you look up here at the top, you see we have our console ID settings. The options are off and then unit IDs 1 through 4. Choosing unit ID number 1 will apply the bit depth and latency settings to your R-series device. Choosing unit IDs 2, 3, or 4 will mean that the bit depth and latency settings remain local. If you choose off as your option, then that console will not have control of the headamps in the R-series devices. Next to this section, we have our secondary port. This is where we can determine if we are in daisy chain or a redundant configuration. Down in the bottom left-hand corner, you have your Dante patch by section. Your two options are this console and Dante controller. When your unit ID is set to ID number 1, the Dante patch by setting is this console. This means that you can go and patch the R-series devices directly from your console. If you change it to Dante controller, then all patch changes must be made from your computer using the Dante controller program. If your unit ID is set to 2, 3, or 4, the Dante patch by setting will change to Dante controller automatically. Next to that section, you have your bit depth options. The two options are 24-bit and 32-bit. We recommend that you use 32-bit whenever using gain compensation, but 24-bit is the default setting. Next to this section, you have your latency settings. The latency settings will depend on the configuration of your network. You can determine how you should set your latency by looking at this table down here at the bottom. Let's go ahead and take a look at the device mount section. Here on the device mount tab, you can see the default configuration. That's two RIO3224Ds and Dante Virtual Sound Card already mounted to your console. Here, I can see that my two RIO3224Ds are actually connected, but Dante Virtual Sound Card is not connected yet, and it shows its setting as virtual. If I wish to add additional devices to my console or change this default configuration, I can do that here on the Device Mount tab. I'm going to go ahead and touch where it says number 4. That's going to open up my Device Mount window where I can select the different devices. If you touch Device List, right underneath where it says Online, you can see all the devices that you have on your network. So I can add this RIO1608 to my console. I can add the R08 to my console as well. If there are any other devices that you wish to add and they're not currently on the network, you can also do that from the device mount window. The way we do this is open up the rack where you want to place that device and then choose it from the supported device list. Finally, let's take a look at the remote HA assign tab. On this tab, we can decide whether or not the headamps inside of our R-series devices will change when we recall a scene. This is the default configuration. In some setups, such as when you have multiple consoles, you only want one of those consoles recalling the headamp inside of the R-series device. So to change this setting, we simply touch here and then turn off the with recall parameter. Now, that additional console will not change the head amps when it recalls a scene.